So what you want to do is get your fire big enough to signal an airplane, and you know you'll be able to cook a piece of chicken on it. I mean, it's good. You know, if you can signal an airplane, you can cook a piece of chicken.
I guess I'm a dad joke. If you didn't like it, you're not funny. Smells so good. Give it a little whack. Really get some of those aromatics. So sweet. So sweet smelling. It's really good in tea. I'm gonna put that at the base of my fire because it just, all these dry leaves are gonna burn real good. All of them, I feel like I use all of the plant. I burn all of them. All the dry pieces. Still do a little charcoal. So this is real charcoal. This is just the rest of the bag. You know what I'm saying? It always makes a fire. I don't use a chimney starter. Maybe it'd be beneficial, but whatever.
Run your home from here, buddy, but I'm sure you can find your way.
I'm gonna find a spider in my house, take it outside. Because we're all the same. You know what I mean? We all come from same thing, same place. That's neither here nor there. Yeah. So just because I don't want to I like it a lot. I'm gonna rake up some of this pine straw I got around here. I'll turn the sprinkler on and I'll wet the grass around. That way I don't get anything that gets out of hand. A quick splash. Just getting the water, just getting the perimeter of the grill wet. Prevent any fires, don't want any stray pieces of coal and lemongrass goodness to set my house on fire.
One hour later, 2 hours later, 3 hours later.
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time, cards.
I just wanted to mound it up because it's in my nature. That's what my people do. We make mounds. Man, that lemongrass, that just fits it right up. I'll show you guys this trick, man. I'm from the south. So I'm just gonna raise this above the fire. That way it can burn off everything. You know what I'm saying? Get it nice and hot. These some jalapenos that I grew. You know, they were just chilling in the yard. So we just let them smoke. I mean, they're still good. I know that the birds like to come and eat them. So I like to have the birds come to kick in with me. All right, so while we were inside prepping, the fire did its thing. The coals are nice and white, nice and hot. My little log cabin over here, it has collapsed in on itself. I put this over here so I can get a little bit of the smoke permeating. And while this is hot, it's got a little bit of indirect heat. I want to put my butternut squash over here on the indirect heat. And eventually I'll move the chicken over there because I want to get the skin nice and crispy. All right, so a good rule of thumb to know when your fire is hot enough. If you can hold your hand over it for more than 5 seconds, then it's not hot enough. You need to lower those grates and get down a little bit lower. But this is perfect. It's about 3 to 4 seconds and I gotta go. And I don't have